quick look on big news so far.
The report of Rashtriya Janata Dal, which contested the polls in alliance with the Congress and emerged as the single largest party with 75 seats in 243-member house, is unavailable on the website, but the party said it spent 7 crore 93 lakh on electioneering. The Bahujan Samaj Party, which won the one seat and shown the expenditure of 4 crores, the BJP won 74 seats and formed the government with JDU. 43 seats and other smaller parties spent amount 25 crores on the travel of its stars and campaigner. During the polls, including on helicopters, the BJP's expenditure was around 30 crores less than in 2015 election, while the Congress, Janata Dal United and RJD spent more than 2020 polls. The BJP spent over 100 crores and the Congress 18 crores and RJD 94 lakh in 2015 assembly polls. The magistrate's courts in Dominica and denied bail to fugitive Mehul Choksi after the state attorney of Dominica argued that he is facing 11 offences in India and extradition proceeding in Antigua and could be a flight risk, according to the reports in local media. The matter has been adjourned to June 14 when the illegal entry charge will be hardly interestingly. The state attorney Sharma, while listening the illegal entry charges against Choksi, also informed the magistrate that entered Dominica illegally on May 21st. Till now, it was being claimed by his family and lawyer that he went missing from Antigua on May 23rd. Rakesh Pandit, the leader of Bharatiya Janata Party, was shot dead while his friend Mustaq Ahmed's daughter suffered injury in the shooting and was hospitalized in a critical condition. Rakesh Pandit, the leader of Bharatiya Janata Party, was shot dead while his friend Mustaq Ahmed's daughter suffered injuries in shooting and was hospitalized in a critical condition. People Anti-Fascist Front, the group, claimed responsibility for killing in the statement that accused Pandita for creating a network of informal drug trafficking and immoral activities. It added it was keeping an eye on the activities of the forces. Police said PAFF appears to be a front of militant organization active in South Kashmir and added security forces have cordoned off the attack scene and launched a search operation to nab the assailants. They added the Pandita's personal security forces were not accompanying him when he was attacked. Police city then said should have avoided going in the Naib village without his security cover, which was provided to him along with the secure accommodation in Srinagar. Dera Sacha Sauda Chief Gurmeet Ram Rahim under a CT scan a postgraduate Institute of Medical Science on Thursday morning after he complained of stomachache. A PGIMS officials and Ram Rahim was brought from the Sonaria jail at 6 a.m. His condition is stable. We have examined him and conducted a CT scan. The report is awaited. The official said Ram Rahim was sent back to Sonaria jail near Rohtak under tight security after the scan. Former actress Sana Khan stood up for herself in front of her over 4 million Instagram followers, where one person commented about her appearance in a recent post. Sana announced her retirement from the entertainment industry last year before she married Anas Zayed. On Wednesday, Sana posted a picture of herself wearing a hijab and holding a container of coffee. Itna padhai likhai kasht karke kiya fayda, wahi to sabke jaisa padke andar rehna. The person wrote, Sana responded, if despite wearing a veil, I can do my business, have amazing in-laws and husband, what more I want? Most important, Allah is protecting me in every way and have completed my education too. So isn't it a win-win situation?
That's all for today. For further updates, stay tuned with News 19.